I normally ask people like 3 or 4 questions. Would you be up for answering them?
Tom.
3 easy ones and a tricky one.
Talk one at a time.
So first of all, what do you think of animals in general?
They're great. I love them so much. I had one, but
me
I
too.
So many animals, but they've all died on me. Like whenever I was 2, I had a dog. Her name was Daisy. She ran away and she got ran over by a car.
That's sad. I'm the same. I've always loved animals. What about you?
I have a dog and he's like the love of my life.
Yeah.
I love him.
Cool. Right. I agree with you. Right. We agree on that one. What do you think of people who abuse animals or animal abuse in general?
They're just really, really terrible for like abusing animals and all. It's like they'll probably end up getting put somewhere.
What do you think?
Karma will get them.
I agree. So, third question is animal abuse. How would you describe abuse? What would you qualify as abuse?
Like hitting them, like hitting them for something they didn't do, and just like not treating them right.
What about you?
Starving them.
Something similar, yeah.
Starving them and like hitting them enough.
Let me give you my definition. You tell me if you agree or not. So, it would be physical or mental harm to an animal, especially when it's not necessary. All right, so self-defense would be different. If a dog attacked you, you'd be allowed to fight them off.
Yeah.
Okay, would you agree with that? Are you going to say something? No?
No.
I thought you were putting your hand up. Right, fourth question is the hard one. This is why I'm here, because I'm trying to make people think. What about the animals that we take into slaughterhouses and we turn them into leather and we turn them into burgers and sausages?
I get that. I'd say if, see, for the first time, like, my mummy told me beef was cow. I was like, mummy, I'm going vegetarian.
There you go.
But then I started eating sausages the next
day. And the reason I'm not judging you for that is because I used to eat it too. I don't anymore. I'm vegan now and I'm an animal rights activist. What about you, by the way? What about those animals? Do you ever think about them? Like cows and chickens and pigs and sheep?
Yeah, I eat it, but it's not me killing them.
Yeah.
But like, I've eaten beef before, but it's not me killing them.
I know, but here's the way you need to think about it. Because I used to think kind of like you as well. Supply and demand. So if you buy the product, they're going to keep doing it for you. Do you understand how supply and demand works? So indirectly, when you go into a shop and buy one of those products, you're literally paying somebody to do something to an animal that you would probably never do yourself. Like, we shoot them in the head, we electrocute them, we cut their throats. I can't see how that can in any way be justified if you can just buy something else. You don't have to buy, you can buy vegan sausages, you can buy oat milk instead of dairy milk and all those things. So considering that all those things are available in every supermarket and Starbucks and Nero and Little Wing do a vegan menu, Dr. Martens do a full vegan range of shoes, then what would be the justification on, all right buddy, what would be the justification on doing those things to like young animals when we don't need to? Have you ever thought of that before?
Yeah, I have.
Yeah. And what do you think? Can you think of a justification, really? I'm not trying to catch you out, by the way. I'm genuinely not.
Kind of. Like, I have thought about it.
Yeah, of course you can.
I used to be vegan and I used to buy all that stuff when we said I had to stop being vegan because it was too expensive.
Right, okay. It's not any more expensive than meat products. It's genuinely not.
It's like,
not.
It's like a person.
You can buy Linda McCartney sausages, for example, a pack of 6 for £1.50. So if you're making a curry, instead of putting a dead chicken in your curry, you can just use sweet potato or chickpeas or lentils and just use those things instead. And they're really cheap.
I want to be vegan again, but my mommy won't let me. She keeps saying it's too expensive, but it's not.
It's not.
That's what I keep saying.
I'm going to give you a card each in a second. It's just a matter of a little bit of knowledge and knowing where you can buy. You don't have to go down, like Nutmeg down there, do expensive stuff. You can go in the Tesco's and buy all the same products for virtually the same price. So if it's the same price, you can be healthy without eating animals, then I can't see there's a justification in any of it at all. Like, if your dog, for example, would you take your dog to a slaughterhouse and let them do to your dog?
Yeah. Absolutely not.
No way.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So do you think a pig, for example, or a sheep feels any different when they go to a slaughterhouse and somebody's hanging them upside down and like somebody coming at you with a knife? That's the most terrifying thing you can think of. Yeah. So how do you think those animals feel when they're standing in line and somebody's hanging them upside down and they're watching the ones in front being knifed in the throat and bleeding out and they have to stand there and watch it too? It's horrible.
No, my daddy watches stuff like that and I always scream at him. I always like shout at him. I'd be like, that's horrible to watch.
What does he watch? What do you mean?
He watches like fishermen and then he watches people catching pigs and all doing that. And I always
see, that's not me at all.
I can't.
always loved animals and I would never, like you girls, I would never harm an animal.
I know, my dad, the people like take all the wool off the sheep, yeah, and then it sees them getting put in the van, and yeah, then you can see on the back of the van like slaughter or something.
Terrible, even sheep industry as well. Do you know what age we kill sheep at in this country? Lamb. You know what lamb is, right?
Yeah.
So young lambs killed at 12 weeks old. Spring lambs killed at 16 weeks old. Wee baby lambs that you see running around the fields, they're taking a slaughterhouse and somebody cuts their throat at 16 weeks old. Imagine doing that to a wee puppy doggy.
You know, that's what I said to my daddy last night. He was like, but that's a part of the future. I was like, so?
It's part of nature, he said, yeah.
The food chain.
Nah.
I know, that's what I said, man. I was like, it's horrible still. Like, they still have a life. They have probably have kids. They probably have a family.
There is a food chain, right? Yeah. So carnivores eat other animals, that's part of the food chain, but we have removed ourselves from that food chain. We don't need to do that.
We can
go to bloody Tesco's and buy any amount of plant-based food. So we're not part of that food chain anymore. It's 2023, we don't need to live like cavemen anymore. We can...
I know, I barely eat meat though. Like, I see in McDonald's sometimes I get like vegan burgers, you know.
Have you tried the McPlant? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's really good.
It's so nice.
KFC do vegan chicken nuggets that people tell me taste exactly the same, if not better.
My sister's been vegan for 5 years and all she likes, if she orders McDonald's or KFC, that's what she gets, like the chicken nuggets.
Does she not live at home with you, no?
She does.
Right. So how, I mean, you tell your mum if your sister's being vegan then...
No, but she's like 18, so she buys, she has her own job to buy her own food.
Okay. Surely you say to her, buy me a wee bit extra and I'm going to be vegan too, and then you'd be sweet.
I always get her to buy me extra chicken nuggets when she gets out of KFC.
There you go.
Because they're amazing.
I know.
They're actually really nice. The other day, my brother, it was Tuesday I think it was, and my brother ran to KFC with my granddad,
yeah,
and he got food poisoned from the chicken.
Yeah, because chicken's really poisoned, like salmonella, like food poisoning.
I was like, Ian, what was it? And he said, I think it was the salmonella, I don't think it was cooked properly enough, yeah, because he said it was pink in the middle, and
yeah,
also I seen all over TikTok, like the on Thursday, some woman, she was chopping up all sorts of animals for their dogs.
Yeah. See, people say it's natural for us to eat animals, but we can't eat animals without cooking them. Like, normal carnivore, what will they do? They'll catch a lion will catch a zebra, they'll tear open their stomach and they'll just eat them raw. You try and do that, you'll get really sick really fast. So that to me is an indication that we really shouldn't be eating animals, we should be eating plant-based products instead. You don't get sick like that from eating a lettuce or eating a carrot, you know, that just doesn't happen. Girls, you've been great. I'm going to give you a card each, is that okay? Yeah.
I'm wearing a leather jacket right now.
Leather,
it's
really
leather, thank you.
It looks like faux leather to me.
Yeah.
Look, I went vegetarian, strict vegetarian when I was 19. But I still wear leather and stuff. I was trying to justify it to myself like it was a byproduct. And if you ever see an animal being skinned for their leather, it's absolutely terrible. Really, really terrible. So I'm going to give you one. Do you want one as well? Oh, you're okay. There you go. That's my YouTube at the bottom and my Instagram there. I'm going to ask you to watch one thing on that. See the one here, the best speech you'll ever hear? That's the one I tell everybody to watch. It's a bully guy in a classroom in America, university lecture. Sounds as boring as hell. I'm not into talks online. But that is literally the best thing I've ever watched in my life. I was 5 minutes in and I thought, why am I wearing leather jackets and why am I wearing leather shoes? Like you said, like I was doing it like not so many years ago as well. And I was like, I don't have to, I can just buy... Like that probably, can I feel that? You don't
yeah, it's fake.
That's fake leather. But it looks exactly like a leather jacket. So then what would be the excuse for wearing an animal skin when you can just buy something that looks exactly the same? Yeah. Like I say, Doc Martens do a full range. These shoes I'm wearing are... look, see here? See what it says on these, on my sole?
Vegan?
Yeah. So those are vegan leather. Those are full leather. Super Dry do a full range of vegan shoes. So
I have vegan Dr. Martens shoes.
Yeah.
I wore them for Christmas.
You're almost there anyway. So you tell your mum and dad, like, I started doing my own cooking when I was 14.
My daddy
myself.
Know what I want to do with my mummy. I want to do cooking.
Yeah, there you go.
It's my mummy who cares, it's not my daddy. My daddy doesn't care. He said if I want to go vegan, I can go vegan, but my mummy keeps telling me no.
Right, I've got a wee message for your parents, so when they're watching this back. You see, when you go vegan, right, people think you have to change absolutely everything that you're eating on a plate. But you think of a Sunday dinner, right? Like a Sunday roast dinner. Potatoes, carrots, turnip, I don't like some of these things, but turnip, I don't like turnip either. Peas, onions, you can have vegan gravy, all those things are all mashed potatoes, all those are already plants, every single thing. The only thing that's got cruelty in it on that plate is the piece of meat. So you can just take that piece of meat away, and put a vegan burger or a vegan sausage or a vegan piece of nut roast or whatever. You can buy like 4 vegetable burgers in Sainsbury's for like £1.20.
My sister asks me, like, I'll eat some of her vegan stuff in the fridge because she has like all section. But like sometimes she shouts at me if I eat too much of it.
What's your sister called? What's her name?
Nath.
Nath. You need to let your sister eat your vegan food. That's a wee message for her. Girls, thank you so much. But give her a wee bit of thought and definitely, definitely watch that.
Yeah, I will.
Speech.
I will definitely.
Cool. I appreciate you. What's your name?
Tony.
Tony. That's a cool name. What's your name?
Alicia.
Alicia. Thank you. What's your name?
Laura.
Laura and?
Olivia.
Thanks very much for stopping. Promise me you're going to watch that speech.
Yeah, I will.
Cool.
I will.
Have a nice day.
I like it.
See you later.